Let us understand how Spark shell application behaves when it gets connected with the cluster. I have a master running in this particular machine and I have two workers attached to this particular machine. I'm going to start a shell. I can start the shell in any machine as long as it's having access to the master. I'm going to start the Spark shell pointing saying where the master is running. So I'll say bin Spark shell and I'll mention the master explicitly. Bin Spark shell master. So it got connected to the master, to the URL that we have mentioned, and the application got started. Spark shell is just like any other application that will get started and it will continue to run. I can verify that within the master URL as well. So this is going to run continuously till I close that particular shell. And I can try out any expression I want. I can try. It read a file, readme.txt. Since I executed the shell in the home location of the Spark, and we have to make sure the same file exists in all the machines. And it provided the result as 103. And this particular application will give the URL in the port 4040. The link over here, it's going to access it through the private URL. Make sure you access the public URL accordingly. So the URL ending with 17. Yeah. So this is the private DNS. I need to access the public DNS as I am accessing it through the browser away from the AWS world. I should be in a position to see what are all the jobs got submitted and what are all the events happened within it. This is just to check whether the cluster is working fine or not. We will see in detail about what is this job, what are all the events, and what are all the completed jobs, the entire detail about how to read data from various sources, that is either from a database or as a JSON file or different serialized file. All that we will be seeing it later.